the same. Why you the one here? So they just stay quiet. Oh, everybody loves a show. Let's only all go. You won't let anybody close. Then I find it's all you got.
That's it, everybody. Thank you. Go home now.
Are you guys ready for the grand finale of the show?
Yeah!
But unfortunately, that does mean the show is almost over. But it's also the best trick of the show.
Yeah!
But then that's one show closer to me leaving the State Fair of Texas. But then I get to see my wife in Toronto.
Yeah!
But sometimes we fight. But then we make up and watch a movie.
Yeah!
But I hate the movie she likes. And then I deal with this. That's really what I have to do. Okay, anyway. All right, I was just trying to verify. Okay, here it is, folks, the grand finale of the show. I'm gonna take this brand new pack of playing cards, take it out of the plastic, and rip it in half. Now, I like doing this at the end, because this is a trick that you people can try at home. You can buy a pack of playing cards on your way home from the fair. You can try to rip it in half. And then you can be like, man, we should have clapped more for that guy in the spandex. Keep it in mind. Now, there is one more trick that I have, which means if I rip these cards in half and then I go away, but you people stay here and start freaking out and go like, encore, encore, then I may come back out and do one more trick, okay? Now, I recognize that an encore usually works best when you don't have to beg for it, like I just did. But every other time that I leave, everybody goes home, and now I don't trust people anymore. All right, so here goes. In the 1950s, strongman shows used to rip telephone books. Has anybody ever heard of that? The old phone book chair? Okay, you've seen a phone book? Okay, anyway, doesn't matter, yeah. The only thing more difficult than tearing a phone book is finding a phone book. So we're gonna do it with these cards instead. I'm not gonna rip my iPhone. I'm gonna put the two guarantee cards right here. They verify that it's a real pack of cards. You can check that out after the show. I'm gonna show you these right here, out of the package. This is 52, brand new, plus the Jokers. That is 54, brand new, American-made playing cards. That is 78 Canadian. Laugh it up, folks. Yeah, it's funny because my economy's crumbling. Laugh it up, ma'am. Thank you. Unbelievable. Wow, that's why I'm here. Stealing one of your jobs. Oh, not so funny now, is it? Okay, too bad. We can all agree that the real joke is that I actually got the visa. Okay, here goes. One, two, three. Too easy.
Thank you, Brandy.
pack of playing cards in half with my bare hands. And folks, just want to say thank you to everybody on this side. Oh, amazing. Look at the people leaving who didn't listen to me. Thank you. Everybody over here, thank you. If your attention span is that short, then you deserve to miss the last trace. But I also want you to know this, that this feat of strength that you're about to witness is something that has been my destiny ever since I graduated with a political science degree from a Canadian university. As the kids, this is the only job you can get with that degree, okay? Just keep in mind. Now, I used to pass the hat for tips. I've done this show all over the world, and I would do the show, and then right before the finale is where I would explain to everybody watching that if you're still here, you essentially owe me $100 each. Folks, but things are different here. We're at the State Fair of Texas. The show is completely free. All I ask for is a huge round of applause for the State Fair of Texas. Come on! That's right. Yep, so they said you're not allowed to pass the hat for tips, but fortunately they didn't say anything about selling stuff after the shows, which is why I spent the last year bending horseshoes, and you can pick up your own for the low price of $100 each. Come on, folks, yay! That's called a loophole. Respect the hustle. All right. Now, I know you're probably all thinking, wait a minute, $100 for a horseshoe, but Mighty Mike, that's too much for me. And that's fair. I just wanted to make it clear that it is not too much for me. That's what's important. No. But folks, seriously, they do cost me a little bit. $10 is what I asked for the horseshoe. I know it's a little bit. Photos are free, $10 for horseshoe. If you think about it, that is actually a great deal for me. So yeah, come up at the end and get that. The markup is insane. Here we go. If you like the show, just let the State Fair of Texas know about me. Hopefully I can come back next year. My name is Mighty Mike Show Online. We got a deal? All right, so let's do this. I'm gonna take a moment just to center myself, because what I'm about to do is very dangerous, so give me just one quick moment here.
Come on, you got this. Hello, Mike. It's your mind. I want you to focus on your breathing.
Okay.
In, out. Why didn't you buy Bitcoin in 2016? It isn't as funny as you think it is.
People aren't laughing as much as you want.
You should have bought Bitcoin in 2017.
What does your dad think of it?
Why didn't you buy the
Okay, I'm calm now. I can do it. Okay, here we go, folks. This is it. It's time to get your Instagrams ready. Get your Snapchats ready. Get your TikToks ready. All the old people, get your eyeballs ready. It's all they got, kids. No app. Here we go. Yes. I wonder if we do this like a... We do a clap for the music. That might seem more epic. Oh, it's working. Even the people on the stairs clapping really helps. Thank you. Okay, here we go. All right, here it goes. You gotta clap, so you're gonna ruin the video. Clap! It's not about you, it's about the TikTok. Never seen the internet before? Come on, let's go, let's go.
We were breathing underwater, out of place all the time.
I'm juggling a sledgehammer. I expected more applause. It got sketchy there. Okay. Great.
Is this my life?
Folks, are you having fun? Yeah. Then I did my job. I